welcome to our exclusive review series on top business analytics program. Like in the previous video, we discussed in detail about MIT Sloan School of Management's business analytics program. Today, we'll be diving deep into the analysis of UCLA Anderson School of Management's business analytics program, and we'll figure out slowly whether it is the right fit for you and you should choose to get into it. Let's dive straight into it. Let's start with a little bit of background. UCLA, that stands for University of California, Los Angeles, has been a university that has been known by each one of you. It is a university that excels in academia and also that it has its successful graduates working all across the globe. This university, in the year 1935, decided that they should get into management and related courses. So in 1935, they founded the UCLA Anderson School of Management and they have not looked back ever since. Further, they introduced various data savvy programs, and one of these programs was business analytics course offered by their Anderson School of Management, which we'll be talking about in detail in the segments that are to come. First come first, the question is, why MSBA from UCLA or why business analytics from UCLA Anderson School of Management? So firstly, this is a STEM certified course. That is, it will take you scientifically and technically through all the requirements that is needed for this particular data and business intersection. Next, this is a 15-month program. And for international students, it is a cherry on the cake because it offers you an extension and a work experience that will boast about you in the future experiences that you are about to have. Next, this is a holistic program, as they say. So basically, they'll be theoretically training you and they will also be practically training you. So you know all the technical details and you know how to apply it to solve complex business problems in the future. Speaking of standing out, let's talk about the ranking. So according to the QS World Ranking of 2024, UCLA Anderson School of Management's Business Analytics program has been ranked on the top pedestal, that is number one. Just like we discussed in our previous video, that it is just followed by MIT Sloan School of Management's Business Analytics program on number two, and HEC Paris and other programs on number three, and so on. That is, it has been consistently there in the top three programs that is promising you a great and bright future ahead for sure. Now let's talk about who you will be learning alongside with, that is the class profile. If we dissect the 2024 class profile, around 117 students were admitted. That is telling you about its highly selective and competitive nature. These students have an average age of 24 years and an average work experience of 2.1 years approximately. Now, out of them, 46% are women. That is promising you a good gender diverse pool of women in STEM as well. Now let's talk about the most important segment of the video, that is the entry requirements and what do you really require on your checklist to get into UCLA Anderson School of Management's Master in Business Analytics program. So here's a rundown for you. Number one, GMAT or GRE score. Now you definitely take into account that you need to submit GMAT or GRE score. Now, if we talk about the GMAT focus score, you need to have at least 665 and above on an average that you're required to get into it. And all of these scores are valid for 5 years. So yes, your highest score will be considered, but you definitely need to submit that. Now, international applicants, if English has not been your primary language and you cannot prove it professionally, you definitely have to take this. So you can either take the TEFL or the IELTS test, and in the IELTS you need to have a band of 7.0 and above. In today's data-driven world, programming is extremely crucial, and if you want to step into this technical and tech-savvy course of business analytics from UCLA, you definitely should have a knack for programming, that is computer programming specifically. So you need to show that you have an experience in SQL, Python, C++, and so on. Your academic background is heavily scrutinized, so you need to show your academic record through your academic transcripts. Please submit all in order and you'll be good to go. Now about talking in second person. So you need at least two letters of recommendations. Now these should come from people who know you really well. They can be your university professors or your ex-employers, and they should know how to talk highly of you. Now we come to the more romantic part of applications, that is the essay. So you need to hand in 3 essays on diverse topics. Through essays, the admission committee is really trying to get inside of you. That is, they're trying to get to know about your opinions and whether you will be a valuable asset for them or not. While work experience in quantitative field is not necessary, it is always recommended. So if you have an experience, particularly in research, etc., so definitely mention them. After this, you have all the documents, that is all the ingredients necessary to make your recipe. So basically, you're going to submit your application after double checking. And if you're really selected, we come to the final part of the admission process, that is the interview. So you'll have to be present in front of the admissions committee, and they'll get to know how much were you being honest in your resume, essays, etc. in person. Now the UCLA MSBA program is a significant investment for you. So basically, if we talk about the tuition fees and other related fees, firstly, you need to submit a $200 non-refundable application fees. Now, if you are selected after the rigorous process that we just discussed, you need to submit another $2,000 of non-refundable fees to lock your seat. Next up, you need to pay your tuition fees, that is approximately $75,000 or $76,000. If you couple this up with health insurance and other student-related fees, you will have an approximate of $86,000 of fees. Don't you worry, there are numerous scholarships and fellowships to cover you up. So basically, glance through them according to your requirements and definitely hit that submit button. Now let's talk about the future, your future. After going through this program and after you have completed this program, definitely you have a promising career and future ahead. According to the 2022 of employment report, around 100% of the students were employed within 6 months of their graduations, which is a really positive sign for you. They had an average salary of around $120,000 as a starting, and they had an average signing bonus of around $22,000. So the roadmap looks very flurry for you, where you'll be working for companies like Meta, Amazon, Google, and so on. Definitely, you're learning all these skills of data analytics, computer programming, business and management, and so on. From whom? From the world's best faculty. That is the faculty that believes in 3:1 student to faculty ratio, who have been heavily trained. For example, Professor Philippe Caro will be there, who will share his experience about working with Zara and numerous other companies and leaving their mark everywhere. So professionals are going to train you from day one. So you need to have your attention fixed, and you'll definitely have a good time with them. And that wraps a deep dive into UCLA Anderson School of Management's Business Analytics program. Just like we discussed on MIT Sloan School of Management's Business Analytics Review, you have a fair idea of both the programs and whether they should be on your list. But let me tell you, since it is ranked on number one, you should definitely go for it, and it should be high on your list. Now, these were the very basics, and we'll be exploring such other basics from HEC Paris in the next and upcoming video. So stay tuned, and I'll see you later. This is Ananya, signing off.